Hi everybody, it's Camden Barr. Hi, under this hat. I suppose one good thing about a global crisis is you don't have to do your hair. Anyway, I was playing Lady Bracknell in the wonderful Perth Theatre's The Importance of Being Earnest, Oscar Wilde, and so sad that it's been cancelled and the theatre's had to shut, as well as many places. I hope everybody is as well and safe as possible in this strange time. I am going to give you my autobiography in a handbag. See what I did there? This is my handbag. Aye. It's quite cumbersome. So, let me tell you a wee bit about me. I was born in Glasgow and I was brought up in Ayr. This is the first thing I'm putting in my handbag for that, for the celebration of my birth. This is Rupert the Bear, for those of you that don't know that. It's a squeaky Rupert the Bear. This isn't actually there. I had that when I was away and I saw it a couple of years ago in a shop, another one, and I bought it. I know. Anyway, I was born and I was Glasgow, brought up in Ayr. I went to school, which was handy. I'm just putting that into my bag while I'm still looking at you. There we go. And I didn't do very well at school at all, but sometimes that didn't seem to matter because I was very lucky in the fact that I had a modicum of talent. I could sing a wee bit, I could make people laugh. And when I left school, I eventually managed to get a job in a nightclub as a DJ and a karaoke host. That's my headphones there. Aren't they fantastic? And that was in Ayr. And then it actually went so well that I moved up to Glasgow and I started to work in Glasgow. I worked in the gay bars, Bennett's at the time. It was fantastic. Club X. And I worked through in Edinburgh as well, which was brilliant. A place called CC Blooms. And 7 years, 8 years I was working there. And one day I bumped into my friend who told me that there was open auditions on at the comedy unit. Never had an audition in my life. And I got one. I went to the comedy unit and they were very nice to me and they sent me away. And I thought I would never hear from them again. And then they phoned me the next day. And they says, do you want to be in a radio show? It's called Chewing the Fat. Chewing the Fat was on the radio at first. And we did a series on radio and then it went to telly and then the next thing, I was on the telly. It was great. But before that, I've got to tell you, while I was in the gay clubs, DJing, I came out. There you go, that's a wee rainbow badge there. That was not easy in Ayr in 1991. I'm 48. I'm not hiding that for anybody. I mean, it's on Wikipedia. Not everything on Wikipedia is true, by the way, but my date of birth is. Coming out was a massive thing, but I've been very fortunate recently. There was an awful lot of homophobia at first, but I've been very fortunate that I haven't had much of that in Glasgow. I know very much that it still exists though. So I was working in Chewing the Fat, that's where I was out there, working in Chewing the Fat, filming, up at 6 in the morning. I had been working in clubs, I was pretty nocturnal, and I was doing an awful lot of drinking in the clubs and pubs, and so I was pretty knocked out. So I stopped drinking end of 1998, so I'll put that in for that, because that is actually my favourite drink. I'm so lucky. My favourite drink is water, followed by coffee, a decaf. But through the work that I had in Chewing the Fat, I went into theatre and did work over the world. I mean, what a life, and stand-up comedy and loads of stuff. So that's a wee biography. Autobiography of me. Do you say autobiography of me or do you say biography of me? Do you know what I mean? Anyway, that's a wee bit of my story. All my stuff is in my bag. It's no, actually, I've put it to the side because I wanted to look at you and then I might put the stuff in the bag. So I will put it in the bag because I said I would. And then I'll take it back out and put it back because Rupert sits over there at the side. I wish everybody well. I hope you manage to stay safe and loved in this time, and I'll see you about very soon, I hope. Bye.